Carla's got something to say to you, Phil.
Do we have to talk now?
We sure do. Go on, tell him and get it over with.
You can't tell me anything I haven't known for weeks.
I'm only trying to make it easy on you.
I'm a married man, twice your age, a respectable accountant. It's hard to believe that I could be taken so easily.
I really liked you, Phil.
Yeah, I'm sure you did. But how could you love someone like him?
Look, bookkeeper, don't give me any trouble, huh?
I won't, but the police probably will.
Sit down.
Don't do anything foolish, Phil.
For the first time in a long time, I won't.
You're not that much of a fool.
Look, I've been your accountant for 2 years. I know every inch of every lousy racket you're in.
You don't know what you're doing, Phil.
I said I'm going to get out. I meant all the way out.
Once more, I'm warning you. Forget it and be at my office at 10 in the morning. At 10 o'clock in the morning, we'll both be in jail in a...
I'm Mike Kovac, photographer. I get a lot of calls from people who want help and think a photographer can help them because pictures are involved. But sometimes the calls have nothing to do with pictures.
Mike Kovac?
Yes.
I'm Mrs. Mason, Phil Mason's widow.
Come in, please. Come in.
You have a very nice apartment.
Thank you. Mrs. Mason, as I told you on the telephone, as much as I'd like to help you, there's nothing left for me to do. The police have already made their arrest.
They'll let Larry Gaines off. I know they will.
Not a chance.
What about the other killings he was arrested for and they let him off?
Well, these things happen sometimes, Mrs. Mason.
I don't want it to happen this time. The Lieutenant Donovan, who's in charge of this case, is a friend of yours, isn't he?
I guess you might call him that.
I'm willing to pay you to make sure that your friend does his job.
That won't be necessary, Mrs. Mason.
Is this enough for a retainer? Open it.
It's more than enough, if there was anything that I could do.
I want to see Larry Gaines die for killing my Phil.
Mrs. Mason, the police have a case that can't be broken.
I know better. My husband made a mistake with a girl. After 18 years of marriage, he wanted to be young again. It hurt terribly to lose even a little of him, but to lose all of him.
I understand. And, I'll talk to Lieutenant Donovan.
A man shouldn't have to die for one mistake, should he?
Well, it depends. Larry Gaines made a mistake, and he's going to.
Count it, Gaines.
If a man can't trust the police, who can he trust?
Count it and get out.
You're being very unrealistic, Lieutenant. The DA released me because he thought I was innocent.
Gaines, you're a killer. You murdered Phil Mason. Someday I'm going to get you for it.
In the words of the DA, as related to me by my attorney...
Get out. So quick.
Quick is the hand of justice. If you fellas are ever at my club, the bill's on the house.
Donovan.
If you got anything to say, don't.
Phil Mason's widow just hired me to watch that guy walk all the way to the chair.
Return the money.
What does it take to make a murder charge stick?
A gun helps, a witness helps even more.
You had two of them. The guy that cleaned up the club and Larry Gaines' girlfriend.
You picked the right word, had. I just left the morgue. Cleaning man's laying on a slab.
What hit him?
Brakes didn't work. Hit a lamppost. Very unfortunate accident.
What about Carla Norris?
Larry Gaines' girlfriend didn't see a thing.
You gonna let her get away with that?
Mike, I only follow the laws we got. I don't make new ones. I can't force her to testify. Would you like to see a statement? Would you like to see what begging, threatening, pleading got us?
I would like to see nothing but you get Larry Gaines.
He's gunned down two men already and gotten away with it. Sooner or later, I'll catch up with him.
Donovan, this is not a hood that was killed. This is an ordinary guy who slipped an inch and was buried 6 feet.
Stop shoving, Mike.
Well, then get Carla Norris to talk.
She won't talk. She's suddenly gone blind.
All right. I don't know what you're going to do, but I'm going to earn my money.
How?
How? I'll introduce you to a good eye doctor. That's how.
Mr. Kovac?
Yes.
I got your card.
Sit down, sit down. I was told you prefer champagne.
Yes, thank you. If you want to sell me publicity...
No, no, I take family portraits. If you'd like to see a sample of my work, I have a very nice picture of the Phil Mason family. The husband, the wife.
Are you from the police?
Card says photographer. I do a little bodyguard work, too. You ever find yourself in need of one?
Now, why would I need that?
Your boyfriend might get nervous.
Excuse me, Mr. Kovac. I've got to change.
Hey, wait a minute. Take the card. You might need me sometime. Hey, that's pretty nice, pretty nice. Gift from Larry?
Mm-hmm. An engagement ring.
Inscribed?
Naturally.
Well, for your sake, I hope it doesn't say till death do us part. I had Carla shook up a little. I knew that words alone wouldn't make her talk, but pictures might. And when I saw Larry Gaines helping a tipsy customer, I had my first shot. Here.
I'm as sober as the... What am I sober as?
Come on, Freddie, I'll take you home.
Pictures sometimes lie. A little cut out, a little retouching. And this one should at least start an argument.
Hi, honey. Want to see me?
A messenger delivered this a few minutes ago.
That's me.
I'm Myrna.
Where'd you get this?
Mike Kovac sent it to me.
Wonder where he got it.
I was wondering the same thing, Larry.
Honey, you're not going to accuse me of trying to make a play for this kook, are you?
She wasn't a kook last year.
That was last year. I haven't hardly seen her since then. And never alone. The pictures are phony. Answer your question?
Maybe I was silly to be jealous, huh?
Honey, I'm never gonna leave you. And don't you ever leave me either, huh?
Now, why would I do a thing like that? I love you.
Well, you just keep on loving me, and we'll both be happy. Very happy. See you after the show?
Naturally.
Got it all off?
Mm-hmm.
Followed Larry Gaines and photographed his routine using a sequence camera, an automatic. I kept on after Larry Gaines. He led a fairly dull life, which I was trying to make interesting. And I finally hit pay dirt. Wait a minute now. You say what you have to say and get out.
It's kind of cool out. You better put your coat on, huh?
We going someplace?
Larry Gaines wants to say goodbye to you. He's leaving town for a couple of weeks.
Out. You tell Larry Gaines I'll be here when he gets back.
He wants to say goodbye to you personally. I got one, too. The coat. Oh, hold it. I just like to make sure, you know?
Well, if you just put your guns down, I'll show you I don't need one.
Look, pal, in case you didn't know it, that's what you've got to prove. Let's go, huh?
$50 to get the gloves, Mike.
It's all right.
You didn't tell me why.
I know why, Les.
You ain't sore, are you, Mike?
Sore? Did he pay you?
Yeah.
Then I ain't sore.
Strip down.
I understand you're going away.
Just for a few weeks.
Have a nice trip.
You know, killing you would be inconvenient right now. So I'm going to take the personal pleasure of cutting you to pieces.
And if you miss, your two hoods here gun me, huh?
I was middleweight champ of my division in Germany. We had some rough boys over there.
3-minute rounds?
No. I'm just gonna keep right on belting you. Now, Larry. No. Let him go.
Hey, Larry, the boys in your division ever tell you that you were a sucker for a left hook? I'll see.
Good fight, Mike. Real good. You all right, Mr. Gaines?
Go away.
Get out, punchy.
Good boy, that Kovac.
It's a shame.
Yep, a real shame. Would have made a great pro.
Hello, Mike.
Hello, Lieutenant.
Thought with Larry Gaines out of town, you'd be catching up on your sleep. Why the stakeout? Just doing a little mining, Lieutenant.
Well, you got a good chance of hitting dirt. About 6 feet of it.
I'll call a policeman if I need any help.
Do that.
Hey, Lieutenant, why don't you go out and chase public enemies, huh? I've already lost her once tonight. I don't want it to happen again. Besides, I've arranged for a pal of mine to meet her.
Go home, Mike.
I'm not sleepy, Lieutenant.
That's funny. Neither's the guy that's watching you.
Live in this apartment?
Oh, yes. I think they live on the second floor.
Thank you.
One week. I'm gone 1 week in this. Who's the guy?
How would I know? I was coming home. A man stopped me and asked me if I knew where the Kirklands lived.
Oh, come on, Carly, you can do better than that.
It's the truth.
Okay. So it's another trick of Kovac.
That's exactly what it is.
But you're walking into your apartment.
I can see that.
Look, honey, I don't want to make too much of this. Now, maybe he's an old friend. If he is, just say so and we'll forget the whole thing.
I never saw the man in my life before.
I've got to know that I can trust you.
Have I ever led you to believe that you can't?
If I can't trust you, as much as I love you, I...
What are you saying, Larry?
That it's important to me.
I'll remember that.
I'll see you at the club later.
Hello, Mike.
Hello there.
I'm returning your card. Can't we have some more light?
Yeah.
Aren't you going to offer me a drink?
No.
Are you surprised to see me?
No, I'm never surprised. That's part of my charm.
Are you disappointed?
Well, not yet, no.
That's nice.
You know, you've got more poison in you than a rattler.
Oh, I'm not as dangerous as all that.
You were to Phil Mason.
But you're different.
Yeah, I'm different. The difference is I'm alive and intend to stay that way.
You could have a whole lot more fun out of life if you tried.
Carla, come on. Stop playing Theta Bear. Make your pitch.
Those pictures you've been sending to Larry aren't very funny.
I didn't think they'd get any laughs, but I'll bet they're getting plenty of action, huh?
Well, I'll admit that Larry has a bad temper. That some of the things he does isn't always legal. But...
Like the murder you witnessed?
I told Lieutenant Donovan I didn't see a thing.
Carla, let me remind you of something. Your boyfriend has already killed one witness.
An accident.
An accident. How do you know you're not being set up for one?
Because Larry loves me.
Then what are you doing here?
Just asking you to stop giving me a bad time.
Lady. I like the way you ask a favor. But as long as you're the only witness against Larry Gaines, you're trouble.
Keep taking your pictures, Mr. Kovac. Take as many as you want.
Thank you, I will.
And whatever you're after, it won't work. Because I won't testify against Larry.
Well, in that case, I'll do you a favor.
You will?
After your accident, I'll send flowers. They said it was all right for me to come in.
Who said?
Okay, so I didn't ask.
Mike, speak your piece and get out, huh? I got 100 things to do.
Donovan, you have a man tailing me. How about having a couple of your men stick close to Colonel's?
Why?
I got a hunch.
About what?
Larry Gaines is beginning to tighten up and Carla's falling apart.
Why isn't she coming here?
Because you'd never make it. Larry has a hood tailing her all the time.
Maybe if I bring her in, she'll give me a few answers.
No, no. You've got to give me a couple of more days on that.
What if she doesn't last a couple of more days?
Well, there's that chance.
I don't like the arch.
Donovan, a man was killed. She was gambling then.
So far, she's gotten away with that.
Well, if her luck runs bad, maybe I can switch the dice for her.
And if you get caught?
My insurance company will be very unhappy.
Okay, Mike.
Thanks, Donovan. We covered 3 department stores, a beauty salon, and wound up outside Carla's apartment. Carla knew Freddie was following her and didn't seem to care. I had a hunch he knew I was following him, but he didn't know the police were behind me.
Mike Kovac brought this to me personally.
Don't tell me this bothers you.
Everything you do bothers me.
Look, the man in the picture is a pal of yours and you know it. I didn't invite him into the car. He saw me alone and tried to make some time. You don't know his reputation.
Don't I? I know his reputation.
What are you talking about?
It's funny, you bought airline tickets this afternoon. Your bags are packed. Somebody would think you wanted to get rid of me. I bought this for you. Where are you planning on using it?
On the coast. I got a movie offer a couple of months ago and I decided to go out and look into it.
Did you ever think of checking with me before making any sudden moves?
Check with you? Why, he was following me all the way.
Just to protect you?
The way he protected your cleanup man?
It wasn't very smart.
Larry, I'm tired of being smart. I'm tired of the whole setup. I'm leaving for good.
For good? I thought you loved me.
Strangely enough, Larry, I do.
If you run out on me now, I won't know who you're seeing, who you're talking to, or what you're saying.
Larry, you can trust me. If I wanted to go to the police, I could have done that a long time ago.
Understand, Carla, understand. I love you, I really do. But I can't afford it anymore.
Larry, if anything happens to me, they'll know who did it.
No, I'll make it easy. I'll make it like an accident. Something that they didn't foresee. Something unfortunate.
No!
Like falling from a window.
Larry, you can't. It won't work.
Why not? We're 23 floors up.
They'll get you for it.
Make it easy for me, Carla.
A witness. You'll have to kill him, too.
Get out!
Larry!
Out!
Larry! Hold it, gang!
He tried to kill me! He tried to push me over the balcony! He killed Bill Mason and shot him in cold blood!
You stupid fool!
Well, it's better than being murdered.
Take him downstairs.
Hold it. You know, I could have this touched up, but I think I'll leave it exactly the way I took it.